In this video, we are going to review how to participate in a discussion using Canvas. I'm going to select one of my active courses on my dashboard. Some instructors may provide a discussion link on the left for you to access the discussion immediately. Others may embed them in the modules. We will know it's a discussion by seeing a comment box on the left, like this one. However, we notice this is light gray, which means the instructor has already closed it and we can no longer access it at this time. Notice this one is bold and dark, and when I hover, it turns into a link, which means I can still access it. We will see the instructions or the prompt along the top. Instructors may provide additional videos to watch prior to participating. If that is the case, please be sure to watch them. When you are ready to respond to the prompt, scroll down until you see this reply bar. Click on it, and you will be given a text box to compose your reply. Similar to other text editing programs, you will have options to apply bold, italics, underline, modify the color of your font, change the alignment of your font, apply indents, use bullets, numbered lists, or even incorporate links in videos. We're going to give that a try now. So as mentioned, to change the format of a word, we can highlight it and select the option above. Be sure to read the instructions in the prompt, because some instructors may be very particular on how you format your responses. If your instructor requires sources, you may list them here, and if allowed, you may also provide links. You can turn a word into a link by highlighting it and then clicking the chain. You then paste the link, so I'm going to use, for example, Google, and then just click Insert Link, and it will turn this word into a hyperlink once you post your reply. To change the font size, you may highlight your text and select a different size option here. When you are happy with your response, you can click Post Reply. If your instructor has made it so that you can't see other responses until you post your own, that will be notated here at the bottom. If the instructor does allow you to view them regardless of your posting, then we would see them listed here below. I am going to post the reply so that we can see what that looks like. Notice the Subscribed button turned green. This means that you will be notified of any additional posts based on your notification settings. If you do not want to receive notifications for each post, you may simply click the button. If you are searching for a particular student in your class, you may type their name here and go straight to that person. Notice that our post was put automatically at the bottom, and that our picture or our account image is present in our post. To reply to a post, click the reply link in the bottom left. You'll get a text box similar to the text box seen when we did our initial posting, and this is where you can type your reply. When you are ready, you can click Post Reply, and it will attach to that specific prompt. Notice that in replies, our account image is smaller than our initial post. This helps us differentiate between initial posts and replies. Again, anytime you participate, you're automatically subscribed. To unsubscribe, click the button. To move on to the next page of the module, you may click Next at the bottom, or we may scroll up and click on Home to exit the discussion. To view the progress of a discussion, we can also go into our grades and find the discussion that we participated in. As with assignments and quizzes, it is important to monitor your due dates so that nothing is past due. It is common for an instructor to lock a discussion or assignment once that due date has passed, which means you would not be able to complete it. Thank you for watching this video on how to participate in discussions using Canvas.